Hi friends, good morning. I am your Karthik Ravindra Kate and this is Kate Tutorials. In this class, we are going to discuss about non-aqueous solids. It comes under inorganic chemistry. See, till now we have discussed every reaction taking place in presence of aqueous, that is water. But here we are going to discuss the reactions taking place in the absence of water. So it is non-aqueous, means water is absent. How the reaction will occur, that we are going to study in this chapter, that is non-aqueous solvents. And we know that solvents, what is meant by solvents? Solvents are nothing but which has the capability to dissolve the solute particles. That are nothing but solvents. And the good example, the universal solvent, is nothing but our water, which is available everywhere and it is cheap. We are not going to spend any money to water. It is because it is available in our environment. So we should know some important characteristics of solvent. What are the few important characteristics of solvent? Those I have listed here. See, I will read it one by one. The first point is the solvent, that is, it should have high dielectric constant. What do you mean by dielectric constant? That I am going to explain in this series of videos, but not in this video. So the solvent should have high dielectric constant. The dielectric constant is nothing but it is the capability of the solvent to dissociate the solute. That is nothing but dielectric constant. And the next point about the solvent is it should have high range of melting point and boiling point. For example, consider water. See, this is our water which we get in our surroundings. So the melting point or the freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. It is the melting point of water. And the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. See the difference. See, the melting point and boiling point, there is 100 degree of difference is there. So greater the difference, greater will be the its capability to separate the solute. So its melting point and boiling point range should be high. So it is about second point. And the third point is it should dissolve maximum solute. It should not dissolve only NaCl solute or calcium chloride solute. It should dissolve maximum, that is almost all solute. Then that solvent is called universal solvent. So we call water as universal solvent because of these characters. Because it has got high dielectric constant around at 25 degrees Celsius, its dielectric constant is 80. And also its range, melting point and boiling point range of water is 0 degree Celsius, that is melting point, and boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. It has got high range between melting point and boiling point. And also it dissolves maximum solute. So it is a great solvent. And greater the dipole moment, greater will be the polarity, greater it will dissolve. So we know that the structure of water is not like that. We write the structure of water to be like this. It has got two lone pair of electrons like this, and this is the structure of water molecule. And we know that here, because of this electron, the dipole moment will be like this. It has got around 1.86 d, something like that, but I am not sure, but it is 1.8 something, 1.86 d. because of this greater dipole moment of water, it has got polarity. There will be polarity, negative charge, and this hydrogen gets positive charge. So we represent water to be like this. These are the molecules of water like this. If it has got positive because of hydrogen, and here it has got negative, there will be polarity. If we put NaCl in water, what happens is Na will break into Na plus and Cl minus. This is what happens when you put NaCl in water. And these water molecules, which are polar, why they are polar? Because of this dipole moment, they are highly polar, because of which they surround this Na plus like this. See, Because of this kind of structure, what they mix with Na plus and Cl minus, they dissolve. So here it is Na plus, so minus will come here like this, minus minus minus, and here plus 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 plus, and here Cl is there, so plus will come here and the minus will be here. So this is the how the NaCl dissolves in water, and this is the about its water H2O, which we have learned in our junior classes, in our PU as well as in BSc. But in this class we are only going to discuss about non-aqueous solid, not the water, because water is aqueous solid. These are the four important characteristics about water, and I have to tell you some the reaction taking place in water. Consider the reaction like HCl then react with NaOH. What is HCl? HCl is an acid. When it reacts with base NaOH, we are going to get H2O. H will react with OH minus and forms H2O plus NaCl. That is salt. This kind of reaction is nothing but neutralization reaction. The acid reacts with base to form salt and water. It is nothing but neutralization, and this takes place in aqueous medium, that is in presence of H2O. The reactions which I am going to write, they are taking place in water. So I am going to discuss about aqueous. In the following classes, I am going to discuss about non-aqueous solvents. So the next reaction, see, this is a salt, calcium chloride plus H2O. When I put this calcium chloride in water, I am going to get calcium hydroxide plus HCl. See, this reaction is also not balanced, but this reaction is balanced. This reaction is not balanced, and you know how to balance. See, calcium 1, there is one calcium. Chlorine 2 are there, so I put 2 here. So 2 chlorine. See here, total 2, H2 are 2, and here hydrogens are 4. So I need to multiply 2. And oxygen is 2, and here also oxygen 2. Hence the reaction is balanced. See, this I told neutralization reaction, or I can also tell acid-base reaction, which is taking place in aqueous medium, that is in presence of water. And this is here what happens is H2 is breaking like this, HOH, like this it is breaking. So this kind of reaction is nothing but hydrolysis reaction, because the solvent is breaking. If solvent is breaking, it is known as solvolysis. Since here solvent is water, we call it as hydrolysis. The H is going to attack this HCl, and this OH is going to attack this calcium. So we get the product. The next reaction, let me consider this CuSO4 plus H2O. See, this CuSO4, in absence of this water, it will be colorless. When it takes water and it forms the compound like this, CuSO4 into 5H2O, and the color of this compound will be blue, very little dark blue, or I can say bright blue color. See, here what happens is this molecule, 5 molecules of water is attached to this compound like this. So this kind of reaction is called hydration or solvation reaction. Since solvent is nothing but water here, so it is hydration reaction. These are the three reactions which we learnt in our previous classes in presence of water medium. In the following classes, we are going to discuss how the same these reactions occurs in non-aqueous solvents. Non-aqueous solvent means water will be upset. Then I should tell you what are these non-aqueous solvents. So the non-aqueous solvents are nothing but non-aqueous solvents. Let me give few examples for non-aqueous solvents. The first one is liquid ammonia. This is a non-aqueous solvent. The second one is liquid sulfur dioxide. And the third one is liquid HF, hydrogen fluoride. These are the examples for non-aqueous solvents. And moreover, in our discussion, we are going to discuss only these two liquids because this is there in our syllabus. So these are non-aqueous solvents. Here, water will be absent. No water means water is absent in these liquids. This is about non-aqueous solvents, and these non-aqueous solvents come under inorganic solvents. We call inorganic solvent, and the H2O is also comes under inorganic solvent, no doubt. And here we are going to discuss only about non-aqueous solvents, and also we have few organic solvents, but we are not going to discuss here. But for our information, let us know about organic solvents. When we discuss in organic chemistry, there we come across these solvents, and we have seen that C2H5OH, what is this? Ethanol we use as solvent, and also we have seen that ether, we use ether as a solvent in organic chemistry. That is, for say example, RX compound is there. When I treat it with magnesium in presence of ether, we write in presence of ether is nothing but solvent. We are going to get RMgX. This is organometallic compounds, and this is Grignard reagent, which is the famous reagent, and because of which we get step up reaction. If there are 4 carbons, we are going to get, after reacting with this, we are going to get 5 carbons. If R is methyl group, if you want to increase the carbon by 2 numbers, instead of methyl, we should add ethyl. Like this, we are going to get step up reactions. That is the beauty of RMgX. And these are organic solvents. What is this? Ethanol. Alcohol is also organic solvent. Ether, we know ROR. That is also the organic solvent. And a few like N-hexane is also an organic solvent. We have got hexane, and also this benzene is also an organic solvent, and all these are non-polar. These have no polarity, so these are organic solvents. This is toluene. This is also a good example for organic solvents. This is few thing about organic solvent. When we discuss organic chemistry, there we are going to discuss in detail about these. And these are the few important points of solvents. In next class, we are going to discuss about how we are going to classify non-organic solvents. If you like this video, please don't forget to like this video. That is, you should give me thumbs up. And if you feel like to share with all your friends. And if you are not the member of this channel, please be the member by subscribing to it. And I have given the I mark here in my video. There if you press, you are going to get a series of different chapters. If you are interested, please go there and watch it then. Thank you. And let's meet in next class.